variable Chinese Cypripedium species, Cypripedium tibeticum. Here it is growing in a mountain valley on the very verge of the vast plateau region that gave it its name. This lovely plant is a terrestrial orchid of high mountain meadows, scrub forest, and forest margins throughout western China and into parts of India and Bhutan. It is hard to generalize about the flower's color, form, and appearance, as you will see in this video, since it varies so much from variety to variety. This large flowered form with a white base color is very common throughout the Sichuan. This plant is growing in the midst of a travertine formation, a type of limestone that is produced by the precipitation of carbonate minerals out of subterranean waters. Huanglong National Park in northern Sichuan is prime habitat for many terrestrial orchids. Here they make their home on small hummocks between the waterways directly on the travertine rock. In extreme cases, plants grow right next to the water, such as this plant growing on the edge of a travertine pool and waterfall. One should not get the idea, however, of these plants like wet roots. This specimen is growing literally in the middle of a travertine formation, amidst running water on this little island of shrubs. The travertine formation extends for 3.5 kilometers here, down a long, narrow valley. The word Huanglong means yellow dragon, since the yellow travertine rock looks like a vast yellow dragon winding its way down this majestic valley. Huanglong is famous for its many travertine pools and waterfalls, but areas like these are not proper orchid habitat. However, they do set up the possibility of great orchid habitat in the future. The water is constantly changing its course, leaving dry, open travertine formations like this. Here we can already see Cypripediums establishing mosses on the travertine. In time, humus begins to form over the travertine rock, forming a perfect place for Cypripedium roots to grow, as can be evidenced by this glorious group of Cypripedium tibeticum. As the moss layer grows thicker, the pH decreases, and this is a bad thing for Cypripediums, since most Cypripedium species prefer near-neutral conditions. The forest as well grows thicker, shading out the Cypripediums. This group of tibeticum are probably on their last good years of growth. While travertine areas are excellent habitat for orchids in China, any place where limestone is at the surface is equally good, such as this majestic valley. This area is essentially a huge debris flow of limestone rock coming out of the tall mountain valleys all around. The forest here is dwarfed due to the high pH of the soil, and this is perfect substrate for orchid roots to take hold. High up in the surrounding canyons and valleys, the limestone is constantly breaking off and washing down the streams to the valley below. Even on this extreme slope, Cypripediums find a home. However, it is a treacherous existence, since fallen rock always threatens to bury the plants alive, such as this group of Cypripedium tibeticum. This lovely specimen of tibeticum looks very much like the Cypripedium macranthus variety from Japan, known as Hotei Atsumurienu. Further down valley, Cypripediums grow in vast numbers in the ever-deepening layer of humus and moss. Here is a mixed group of Cypripedium tibeticum and flatum. Also notice the rhododendron seedlings that are just beginning to establish. On the edges of the lower valley, forest is taking over, spelling the end of good habitat for Cypripedium orchids. Here, however, a lovely pair of Cypripedium tibeticum continue on. eventually the forest becomes very dense, forming a thick acidic humus layer, as evidenced by this group of rhododendrons. Here the cypripediums fall out utterly since their roots cannot withstand the acidic conditions. In this valley, we also found the unusual dwarf variety of Cypripedium tibeticum, variety Emsion, a self-pollinating form. A completely different habitat for this species is this windy meadow full of dwarf rhododendrons and wildflowers. Here amongst the shrubs, we found Cypripedium tibeticum growing with a number of other native orchids. These flowers had a yellow base color, making the anthocyanin express itself as red rather than a purple, which is what you will see with a white-based flower. Within the horticultural trade, this variety is often known as variety Coriandatum. However, this name is not recognized by most botanical authorities. In another travertine valley, we found an interesting mixed colony of separate relative Cypripedium calcicola. Here is a classic Cypripedium calcicola. And here is an example of a Cypripedium tibeticum from the same area. Plants in this area seem to have characteristics from both tibeticum and calcicola, begging the question, are these plants hybrids? Yellow-based flowered form of Cypripedium tibeticum growing high up on the hillside where grass emerges from cliffs. Is this a pure Cypripedium tibeticum? Does it have calcicola blood in it? No one can be sure. Here is a plant that seems to have a perfect calcicola lip, yet the sepals and petals look more like tibeticum. This plant looks like a perfect calcicola, and yet the sepals and petals are not quite right for that species. We also came across this specimen of Emsionum, which is very close to calcicola. One thing that is nice to report is that this area was full of many young Cypripedium seedlings. In this valley, the travertine formations are still forming, and they're creating on the cliffs, we found a number of plants growing, including these seeming calcicola growing high up on this limestone bluff. Nearby, this very rare double-flowered plant graced another part of the cliff face. So here we have a colony of white-based flowers, yellow-based flowers, calcicola, and seeming hybrids. I had to climb high up on the cliff in order to get a picture of this, and it scared the